Hi guys, this is Gaurav and today we are going to talk about Microsoft Azure. So there's a buzz in the market that cloud computing is going to rule the market in the next 10 years. So to some extent it is true, and there are a lot of market players who are providing their computing services, and Microsoft is one of them. So today we will be focusing on Microsoft Azure. Okay, so let me tell you something about myself. I have over 7 years of experience in full stack development. I've worked with the international client, Australian, US and UK. I'm Microsoft certified, and this is my handlers where you can get in touch with me. So this is my Twitter handler, Gauravich, and LinkedIn address, blog, YouTube, my YouTube channel where you can see this video. So this is the agenda of today's session. So first we are going to talk about Microsoft Azure, then we'll be seeing why Azure, then we'll come to the prerequisite of using Microsoft Azure, and then we'll be creating a sample MVC application using Visual Studio. After that we'll be creating a web app on Azure platform. Then we'll be deploying that MVC application which we created, a sample application, into the Azure environment. So let's go. So what is Microsoft Azure? So Microsoft Azure is a cloud services platform which is hosted on the Microsoft data centers, right? So it is a collection of hell lot of services name it as mobile service, web app service, cognitive service, machine learning, and these kind of stuff. So we'll talk about later that what are these services. But for example, if you have an app and you want to deploy that app into some place, into some cloud, so you need that service which is being provided by Azure. So you can just directly use that service and deploy that app there. So let's take an example, or a very small example, that we create an application, right? And that application uses the DB. So for DB, for example, we are using SQL Server. So we need to install SQL Server for that. And once the application is complete, we need to deploy that application to some place where it can be accessible to the whole company or on the internet, right? So for that we need a dedicated server. So there is a cost involved of having a dedicated server and a SQL server which we are using as a database, right? So and we have to pay it one time, right? And it's not based on what, so if I'm using my application 8 hours in a day, out of 24 hours I'm only using for 8 hours, so it would not be like that I'll be getting paid only for 8 hours. I'll be paid for, so because I've already paid that and I'm using it, right? But Azure has changed the dimensions and dynamics of this operating model. So the new operating model which Azure suggests us is that, so you use my server, you deploy the application on my server, and you use that application or run that application on my server for 10 minutes and pay me only for 10 minutes. So this is the beauty of Azure, that you don't need any operating costs, you don't need to buy anything, you just for the sake of trial purposes, you just deploy an application for 10 minutes and see how it is working, and then just stop that up. So that's what Azure is all about. So that's what I said, it reduces the need of upfront technology purchases. So now I don't need to purchase SQL Server. What I'll be having is I'll just buy Azure SQL, SQL service, and I'll create a DB there, and I'll just store the data there, right? So it would be like that. So I don't need to purchase, for example, currently we are using SQL Server 2016, and after 1 year Microsoft would be launching 2017 or 2018, right? So we cannot upgrade that up, and we cannot have cost involved of upgrading our software. So we can just buy that service and we can just use that service and create the database there only. And so once everything is on cloud, then there is no risk of having it. So it's is it being crashed or not, these kind of stuff. So we are getting avoid from these kind of situations, right? Okay, so it's also enables developer to quickly and easily create application running in the cloud. So it's so simple that you don't need any server, you don't need SQL. So you're just creating an application. You are once you are done, you'll just publish the application and that's it. It would be done and you can just use it, right? So why Azure? So I guess I've told you the maximum benefits of Azure, but let's see what we have in the kitty today. So scale as you need, pay as you use. So when we read this, we try to figure out. So when you create your Azure account initially, you will be so Microsoft will provide you 13,000 credit points. Each credit is equivalent to a rupee, and so you can use it for 1 month. You can create an application, you can deploy it, and you can just play with Azure, right? Now after that, it's your choice that whether you want to go to the pay as you go services, which is a different subscription, which tells you that now your subscription is free, subscription is over, and if you want to use that further, you can just give us a little amount for that and you can play with that, right? And also there is, we can figure out one more way of saying this, right? For example, you are running a fashion website, right? And you have a season. So in the season time, you are just scaling up your application. So when I'm saying scaling up, it means that my server has been increased from 16 GB RAM to 64 GB RAM, because there would be a lot of concurrent user, a lot of it would be coming on my website. So I just need to take care of that. That server should not be the CPU should not be very high, right? And when there is an off season, there will probably 100 users will come into picture, and or 50 users will come into picture, then we can just decrease the scale, and that's how we can tweak our servers. Keeping the same server, we can just change the configuration on the fly, and that will impact the cost, right? Which we cannot do with a dedicated server. Protect your data. So Microsoft has a complete commitment that whatever data, whatever application you're deploying, or whatever data, if it's a SQL data or images or any kind of thing you are storing it, so Microsoft has a full commitment that they will protect your data, and it is totally Microsoft responsibility. Well, they'll take care of that, right? Run your app anywhere. So it's like that Microsoft has a huge number of data centers across 42 regions, right? So it's more than combination of AWS and Google Cloud, right? So if, for example, if I'm sitting in Berlin, Germany, right, and I want to create my application and I want to deploy it somewhere near Germany only, in the Europe only, German region, so I can do that because they do have the data center there. So what is the benefit of that? The benefit of that would be the cost would be as far as I think, the cost would be lower because you are using an area nearby to you. And the second thing would be that it's always when there is any mishappening or any kind of things comes into picture, then you know that which is the place you have to go to just capture your data. So it's we can say it's kind of, you'll be more aware that where your server are placed. And for example, there are certain occasion that US is blocked for a day and US servers will be down. So in that case, you can switch your servers to Australia. So these are the options available that select your region and we'll provide you. So this is what Microsoft Azure provides you, right? Okay, so let's talk about the prerequisites. So what are the prerequisites, right? So for having playing with or starting up with Microsoft Azure, you need to have a Microsoft account, a Microsoft ID, first of all. After that, your Microsoft account should be linked with your Azure account. When you'll be creating your Microsoft Azure account, that you have to use your Microsoft account only, Microsoft ID only. Otherwise, you'll not be able to do that. And this is the below link which you can use to create a free Azure account. So every Microsoft ID can have only one free account, right? So if you have one ID, for example, abc@hotmail.com, you can have an Azure account and you can get 13,000 credits and you can just play with that. Okay, great. Okay, so now what we are going to do, we'll be creating a very simple MVC application using Visual Studio 2017. And very simple application. So what we are going to do is we'll just open the Visual Studio and we'll create a project. We'll choose a empty template. We'll add sample controller and view to that. We'll write some sample text in the HTML file so that we can get to know, and then we'll run the application. Okay, let's run the demo. Okay, so let me just go here and okay, so let me just go here and create a very simple sample project for an MVC application, and let me choose the option to do this. Okay, I guess it's, is it creating for me? Okay, it's not. Okay, so let me just choose this path and let me just call it as sample Azure 13.9, and let me just create that up and let's take an empty template with a MVC checked on that. So it's going to be very simple. Okay, so it has created a sample MVC project for me. Let me just quickly add a controller here, an empty controller whose name is home. And then let me just quickly add this view as well. Right click on that, I'll just quickly add the view. And let me just write welcome to Azure world. Date is 13/9/2017. That's it. And let me just run this application. Okay, so here we can see that's a simple output which is getting produced by that. Let me just close the application, back to our slides. So what is the second thing? So now we'll be creating a very simple web app in Microsoft Azure account. So that what we need to do is we need to just open the portal, Azure portal. We'll sign in using Azure portal. We'll click on new, and within that we'll click on the web app net plus mobile option, select a web app there, fill in the relevant details like name and resource within that, and then click on create, and then go to all resources section, see the newly created resource. I'll explain you, so I'm just reading the step out and let's go. So let me just open the Google Chrome here and let me just open Azure portal. Right, so it's very simple. I go to the new tab I go to the web plus mobile tab, I choose a web app. Then you can see the credit remains for me. So I'll just write sample Azure 6 13 09. This is my app name. Okay, so the my resource name would be, this would be the place where the data would be. So every app has a resource, right? So it's just like an app pool. In IIS, we have an app pool and we can run multiple applications in that. It's just like that. We have a resource group and we can have multiple apps running under the umbrella of one resource group, or we can have individual resource group for individual apps. So every resource group has a cost involved to that, right? So let me just create a resource group, this, correct? And let me just choose Windows and this is a service plan. Just click on create. And if you see here, it will start deploying it for me. So that's here, right? If you see here, deployment in progress. And first of all, it is deploying the resource group for me. And then it would be deploying the application and the service. This, so the resource group has been published with a service plan. So we just need to, so it takes about 30 seconds. So our application, so resource group has been deployed, our app has been deployed. If we see the resource group, this is here. If I see my app services, this is here. So everything is done, right? So let me just go back to my slide and see what happens next. So now, because now what I have done, so I have created a very simple MVC application and then I have created a web app on the Azure, right? Now what I need to do is, I just need to, because my application is ready, my service is ready, I just need to connect both of them and I just need to deploy my code to Azure so that it is visible to everyone, right? It would be visible to on a www on the internet, right? So what would be the step? I'll just open the Visual Studio and Server Explorer in that, and I'll right click on the Azure section, connect to the Azure subscription, then right click on that and on the project and publish. And in the publish, I'll choose the app service section and choose existing, then select the subscription and the created resource group where I want to publish the application, then just click on OK and wait for the application to get published, right? So let me just show you up. So this is my Server Explorer. I just need to do that. Just need to connect with my So if you can see here, this is the app services. This is the resource group. This is the app services which is there. So everything you can access from here as well, right? So this is it. And now what we need to do is, we just need to click on publish and we'll select, because we already have. So you can create an app service from here as well, but that is the more I found it more appropriate way to go to the Azure portal and see how it looks and how it behaves. And instead of doing it everything from here, you should know that how it works, right? So if you want to create it from here, you can do that. Obviously, you can just right click the app service and create new app service, and you can do that, right? But here we'll be choosing the select existing option and we'll have a subscription, right? And now this is my service, right, where I want to deploy my app, right? This is my web app service. So I'll just click on OK. And it takes about, I guess, 30 seconds to 45 seconds to deploy everything on the app and just run the application, right? So it's very it sounds, and it sounds very crazy and easy that you just create the application, you just deploy it on your free Azure account, and you can just share it with your friends and they can see what you have made. So it's pretty cool, right? You don't need to provide any access to them. It is available on internet, right? If they have an internet access, they can access it from their phones, from their mobile, from their tablet. So it's pretty amazing, right? So this is the Azure URL which has been created. So because it's loading for the very first time, so that right might take some time, but so this is pretty amazing. So you are free to share this URL with anyone everywhere, and it would be accessible all over the world on www on the internet, right? So that is the beauty of Azure. So this is what I was trying to, so it's just a kickstart to Azure to understand what is Azure, what it is doing for us. It is doing a hell lot of things. I've just covered one of them, but my motto was that when we see this session and when we finish this session, at least we should know what Azure is, why we are using it, and what kind of ease and ease of development it provides, right? So these are the resources, and these are one of the best resources which I have, which I've studied, and these are amazing resources. First four resources are the Lynda pool site resources, and one of the articles has been written by me on C-Sharp Corner. So that's it. Happy learning, guys. Thank you so much for watching this next session, and one more thing, please share this video on any social platform.